Y'all so ready for this? Y'all ready for this?
Just one verse.
There you go. What's up, everybody? I'm Josh McCuga. Welcome back to a Collider TV Talk on a super
sassy
Tuesday. God, I can never remember it, but we're going to get there. It only taken me 3 weeks to forget all of them, so don't worry about it. We are here every single day at 11 a.m. PST on Collider Video. I want to thank everybody who always tunes in, who comments, who tweets, who joins us for our live Instagram videos before we do every single episode. I want to thank Adam and Cody for always being here at 11 a.m. This is my last show for a little while. I'm going to go get married this weekend, and I'm going to go on my honeymoon, and I'm going to gain about 30 pounds in Italian pasta, so I'm very, very excited about it.
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. I'm going to come back, and they're going to have to expand the frame on my fat face, and I am super excited about it. I'm going to miss this guy to my right. That's the bearded one, David Griffin. Are you going to miss me while I'm gone there?
Of course I'm going to miss you. Man. I mean, I'll see you. Yeah.
I don't know why we're slow clapping for that.
I'm going to miss you. I mean, but I'm happy for you. You're going to go on a nice, extravagant vacation. You're going to have some good food, and you're going to just have a great wedding. Thanks, I'm excited to see it.
Thanks, man.
Can't wait. Yeah.
And our mother of Ginger Dragons, she's going to be holding down the fort here while I'm gone, at least for some of the episodes. That's Grace Hancock, everybody. That's her.
Oh, hello. Good morning. Sassy Tuesday. Guys, send me your Twitter questions. I will eventually answer all of them, but send really good ones because then you're more likely to get picked.
Boom.
Hashtag Collider TV Talk.
Boom. Hashtag Mother of Ginger Dragons. Hashtag Taylor Kitsch's hair is David Koresh.
Grace, basically you're responsible for watch all the television shows now. It's all on you. For the next one. I'm sorry. For the next couple weeks, it's all on you.
Like, guys, it's to the point where I'm trying to, like, I have a Bluetooth speaker plugged into my iPad, so I'm, like, in the shower, like, leaning out the curtain, like, I can still hear it, I got it, we're fine. Like, I'm totally ready to watch more TV.
Or you could just do like me and be like, hey, guys, not going to watch American Horror Story, so we're never going to talk about it. F off. But now, because I'm gone, and I was also talking to Perry and Grace and everybody that are watching it, what we're going to kind of do when we come back, we're going to try and switch up some things. We may talk about as many TV shows as we can. I'm trying to get some people in the office to come in, talk about the shows, have a revolving third chair, a revolving two chair. Who knows? We're going to try and get as much TV covered this fall season as humanly possible. But until then, I'm going to be gone, so it doesn't really matter. All right. Let's start it off. Grace, what do you say?
I say yes. Period. We've gotten our first look at Taylor Kitsch in all of his mulleted glory as cult leader David Koresh in the limited series Waco that's going to follow his 51-day standoff with the FBI in 1993. It's going to be a six-part event series airing in January on the Paramount Network.
The Paramount crossover from
Spike,
Esquire.
MTV. I mean, that's where Shannara Chronicles is going to Spike / Paramount. It's all part of the MTV network.
It's smart to name it Paramount because at least it has some clout now.
Yeah, because Spike, it's like, isn't that like where you watch like the beer pong tournaments is on Spike? Or that Blue
I know, I'm like, isn't that like,
was it like Blue
boobs?
Mountain High?
Blue Mountain State was a great show. It was super funny.
It's just like a bunch of like bros talking about boobs. And
yeah,
it's like,
well, that's hysterical.
Not unlike this table right
Sorry,
here.
Sorry, David. It's not a heady British drama where a kid disappears and the family has to worry about
Hey, we're
going to
talk about some great television on the Great British Breakdown. You just stay tuned.
Boom.
Sorry.
Here's my complaint, and it's always been a complaint about cults in general, is their leaders are always weird-looking dudes.
Well, yeah, I mean, they can't be normal
so
looking.
So if you're following, like, listen, I know the 90s, the mullet was still holding on to survive, and, like, Warrant Cherry Pie was a thing, and, like, you were still holding on to, like, hair metal, but nobody should ever really follow anyone with mullets. Even Yarmer Yager, the Penguin star in the early 90s, had one of the greatest mullets of all time, but did anybody in Pittsburgh really trust him? Of course they did. Do you know why? Because Pittsburgh still holds on to the mullet, hence why we can't get out of 1995. We are trying to as a city, and we are doing our best. But people still have mullets, and that is a problem. It has nothing to do with the show. I'm really looking forward to it.
I'm looking forward to it. Taylor Kitsch is a good actor.
He is.
But he's one of those guys who's been moved around, and the roles he takes don't always do well. I'm a fan of John Carter. I thought John Carter was an entertaining action adventure. No, John Carter's good. Watch John Carter.
David?
But ever since Friday Night, nope.
I'm going to mute you.
Nope.
I'm gonna mute you.
But ever since Friday Night Lights, he hasn't really found his footing yet.
I'm just going to punch that mic off the table. I'm just like,
hey,
get out.
Let me say my piece. I have an opinion, too, and it matters. Here comes Josh. Josh is, wow. All right, well, you know what? This is great. So, folks, we're going to cut, edit this. 3, 2, 1, we're back. Out of the frame. Get out of the frame. We are back with Collider TV Talk. I'm your new host, the main host, David Griffin. We're going to talk about all things British. We're going to talk about the new Oh, you guys are back now. Yep. Okay, all right, so.
It's like Josh's last day. We're just like doing whatever we want.
So what are you going to say about Koresh? Give it to me.
I'm done. That's enough. No, I Taylor Kitschman, those guys who I think has been, I hate saying an unlucky hand because he's not poor. he's done well.
But I know what you mean. Like his roles are kind
but
of
his role,
like
he hasn't had
like,
that role where it's like, that's a Taylor Kitsch role, not since Friday Night Lights.
Yeah. Correct.
So I'm looking for, I hope this is one that puts him back on the map.
Yes.
You know, I mean, they tried to make him a leading star. Looks like they're going to try it again. Yep. And I hope this does it for him because I think he is a talented actor. He was great on Friday Night Lights. And he always goes 100% in whatever he's
great
in.
Great abs, too.
Great abs. He's a handsome man. Even with that mullet,
that's how you become
he's
a
still
actor,
a handsome man with
abs.
A mullet.
Yes.
So I'm rooting for Taylor Kitsch. I hope this does well.
Yeah, me too.
All right, what's next, Grace?
Yeah.
All right. So Bollywood actress Amy Jackson is joining the CW superhero drama series Supergirl in the recurring role of the telekinetic Saturn Girl. And we have these cool new images. Supergirl starts up next week on October 9th.
That was pretty good. Did you hear David do that? Do it again.
That's when you're doing telekinesis.
I didn't know that there was a sound effect for telekinesis. I'm learning a lot.
I feel like Bollywood is like the CW.
They get paid though,
right? No, I'm not. Hold on. What I'm saying
like
is
Priyanka
yes,
Chopra.
No, everybody in Bollywood. First of all, Indian women are ridiculously gorgeous.
So hot.
Second of all, Indian every Bollywood men. Actress they're like, hey, we're gonna bring you over to the United States, and everybody's like. The person's too attractive. My TV just broke.
Right. Yeah.
Is that where what's her name came from? Who's on
Quantico?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She is. Jesus. I mean, my favorite is Padma Lakshmi. Padma Lakshmi from Top Chef. Oh.
She's gorgeous too.
I am so okay. We're gonna take a tangent. That's I'm good. So attracted to Indian men. It's like Dev Patel. Like.
A good looking dude.
But, I mean, look,
bring them all over.
As Saturn Girl, you're like, welcome to the CW, Bollywood. Because Bollywood and the CW are like the same thing. If you're not super attractive, you're not getting on our shows.
It's true.
So go after yourself.
And at some point, there's going to be some really awesome dancing.
If Saturn Girl doesn't come out and her superpower isn't wild dancing, I'm going to be real upset.
Why?
Well, hey, the next big CW musical, Josh. There you go.
Javen. Sorry, I just said Javen.
Javen.
I tried to hold on to see if you guys didn't catch that.
No, I for sure. I was just. Wow.
No, I'm happy that they're bringing more stars. I mean, I hope Supergirl is good this season. I mean, I enjoyed it last season. I thought it was an improvement. I thought the show was better on the CW than it was on TBS. So I'm expecting more
good
things.
Third season lull. It could.
I hope not. I hope not.
The CW junior slump?
The third season's the curse of the CW. Yeah. I hope not.
And they just released some first images and our girl Odette from Banshees.
Yeah.
In those first season images. Mm-hmm. All right, Grace, what's next?
Right. So, okay. Yesterday, FX announced that they're going to have their own kind of Netflix streaming service that's going to be available for $5.99 a month, but it's only going to be available to people who have Cox Communications and Comcast. So you're going to be able to watch all of their original programming, sans advertisements.
Doesn't help
we
me
all have a lot of thoughts.
I have DirecTV, so it doesn't affect me. Yeah.
Here's the problem.
Ooh,
David.
David has.
Hey.
Look at all that money just coming out of his beard. He's like, ooh, wait, hold on.
I watch TV
He's
at the
like,
highest level.
He's like, my Roku's
CBS?
Here.
Yeah.
I'm complaining about the stupid money I got to pay to watch Star Trek, but you best believe I got that VIP package. I got that $10 a month.
Whoa.
No commercials.
Money bags. Ooh. All right, listen.
Making it rain up in here, folks. Yeah, spoiler.
I don't think I can, I don't think I can be on the show anymore.
Good man.
Okay. David coming in like, oh, I'm going to sit through that IBM commercial. It doesn't really make sense. Talk about the 1% over here. I go and get my beard trimmed by a barber. I'm like, you commoners who use an actual thing that you bought at Target that doesn't work that well. David.
I appreciate the finer things in life. I can't help it. I'm sorry. This is the way I live.
Here's the
hashtag
problem.
Blessed.
This show is off the rails, and I'm loving every second of it. Couldn't have picked a better last show. Okay, here's the thing.
Yeah.
Is I think we're coming full circle, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
About 10 years ago, 12 years ago, everybody was like, oh my God, reality TV is ruining the world, right? And then all of a sudden, it was like, yeah, you're right, reality TV blows a donger, and now we're going back to actually good scripted TV, right? And a lot of these, like some well-done shows that are, I mean, it's amazing television. Yeah. But all of these other providers are like, well, Jesus, we're losing so much money via Hulu, Netflix, Amazon, yada, yada, yada. So now we're gonna make a streaming service. Oh, YouTube's we're going to make a streaming service. So what's going to end up happening is everybody's gonna be like, I'm a cord cutter, but I have like 47 apps of like every channel.
Which adds up to about
like
$780.
Bucks.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
Stop cutting your cords, guys. Here's the beautiful part. Is I'm not a cord cutter because I like live sports and I like to have all my live TV. I want the feeling, the warmth in my stomach of when I turn on the TV. I don't have to be like, boop, boop,
or if the website or if the site crashes.
Is that your telekinesis?
Yeah.
No, that's the Roku sound. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
The buffering, the streaming went out. The stream didn't happen. My cable is glorious. I know I pay a premium. I have every channel, but here's the glorious part. When you pay a premium for your channel, you get the HBO app free. You get the Showtime app free. You get all that. So you can watch
CBS All Access.
You want. Well, CBS All Access can all access self out of the friggin' room. Okay?
Yeah.
You can kiss Cody. My all assets. Cody See what Bruce. I did there? I'm out, guys. But it's going to come full circle. People are like, wait a second. Let me go look at my costs. And like,
right.
I don't even get that channel. I miss Epic Caviar's and Travel Channel because I don't have TV. Dummies, stop cutting your cable cords. You get all the apps for free. And you also get the shows. And you can watch them whenever you want. And guess what? They have this really new technology. It's amazing. It only came around like 20 years ago. It's called TiVo or DVR. And you can DVR all your shows, and you can watch them while you're working out. You can watch them on a big screen. You don't have to upload your computer. And I understand that cable is expensive, but all these apps are going to start costing you a lot
more.
Yeah,
you're paying $10 for Netflix. You're paying your $100 a year
Showtime,
for Amazon Prime.
Star.
I mean, once you add it up, I mean, once you get to about $150, you might as well get cable again.
Correct.
Yeah. Because everybody's like, how do I watch the Travel Channel? I'm like, you turn on your DirecTV, you go to Travel Channel, you hit record.
Yes.
I know it's expensive, but if...
Listen, I'm not telling people how to spend their money. I'm just saying.
No, right, of course.
By the time all these networks...
Heading.
Yeah.
All these networks are like, well, I'm not going to give my content to Hulu. I can just start my own streaming service. Like what Disney's going to do with all the Marvel properties.
Yeah, they're pulling.
Netflix.
Yes, if you're going to watch Netflix, if you're going to watch Daredevil and stuff, Disney's going to pull all that eventually. You have to watch Daredevil on the Disney app. You have to pay for that, too.
Boom.
Just keeps adding up. More money.
It's a vicious cycle.
And we're not getting paid by Cox or Spectrum or DirecTV or ATUverse or like Donnie's Cable out and wherever.
I wish I had some of that Cox money, man.
Oh, man.
I wish I had some of that Donnie's Cable money.
All right, what's next, Grace?
All right, so this wonderful human to my right.
Should we play our instruments?
Oh, shit. I'm so sorry. Yeah.
Would you like to play?
Yeah. I like how it was like kind of like a horn, but,
yeah,
like
but you're
played
like playing
on a violin.
Yeah.
It's a new instrument.
I'm a one-man band of orchestral instruments, David, and that's how they say it over in London, which is why we're going to go for David's Great British Breakdown.
So when I talked about this show, Josh was a little confused. He thought it was two shows. He thought it was like The Child and The Time. Like I was saying, like, and there's another show I want you to watch called The Time. No, this show is called The Child in Time. It was a TV movie that premiered, I believe, on Sunday on BBC One, the greatest network of all time. And it has Sherlock himself, a.k.a. Doctor Strange, a.k.a. Benedict Cumberbatch.
I don't think you have to
a.k.a. Khan.
A.k.a. him. Wrath of Khan. Spoiler, Star Trek Into Darkness. Spoiler. He is just such a good actor. He has a show with Kelly MacDonald.
Mm-hmm.
It's they both lose. They lose
Mrs.
a daughter.
Mrs.
Schroeder from Boardwalk Empire.
She's Rowena
Ravenclaw. She's also
Ravenclaw.
A braid. Yeah, Ravenclaw. She's been in a lot of stuff. A great Scottish actress. They lose a daughter. They lose their daughter.
Shocker.
Wow.
Wow. Keep going. Sorry.
Have some sensitivity, Josh.
Okay, my bad.
And it's all about them. It's basically this beautiful story of grief and trying to, you know, get over this tragic loss that they had, and you really can't get over it, you know? You know, okay, so Josh, why don't you tell them what you told me this morning? You know, I asked these guys to watch one extra show a week. One a week.
What? Josh,
one that one is also a 4-hour TV movie.
It was 90 minutes.
But
Josh, tell me what you
shows
said.
Too.
Tell me what you said when he came in this morning. Let me hear
guy.
What you said when
I
he came
said,
this
David,
morning.
You're one of the greatest guys I know.
Here it
amazing
comes.
Dude. But there's no way I'm watching this Child in Time show because I watched the first 10 minutes as I was going to bed. I was like, oh, this will be a perfect go to bed TV show. And as soon as it opened, it starts in that classic British slow motion
the
of the dad walking out like cops around. It's like flashback. And then he walks in and all of a sudden, like, okay, let me say this. The dad walks in, who's played by Benedict Cumberbatch, and he's like, she was right there. She was right there. And Kelly MacDonald's like, what? What? Ah! Like, what is she freaking out of? She doesn't
her
know
daughter's
anything.
Gone.
But she doesn't know anything yet. So there was a complete overreaction. It's like, dinner was on the table. Where'd it go? So after about 10 minutes, I wanted to come in here today and tell you that I love you, but I'm not going to get through the show because I know what's going to happen. Here's what's going to happen.
Oh, boy.
Benedict Cumberbatch, through flashbacks, is going to realize that his daughter is lost. And more than likely, she was lost outside or inside that shopping plaza that they were in at the beginning of the show, correct? Did she disappear from the grocery store?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
She does.
Boom. Through flashbacks, he's going to realize that he and his wife, they couldn't stand the grief and thus split up. But they still care about each other and hope each other are okay, a la Manchester by the Sea. And through a series of investigatory criminals, whatever, they are tracking down their daughter to see if they find her, but they never do. And thus, the story is more about a power of grief and loss of child than it is about finding the person that stole their kid. Yes or no?
That's partly what the story's
that's
about.
The
that's
story.
It's part of it. But there's a lot of like magic in it, like because there's visions. I mean, Grace, you stuck through the whole thing. You watched all 90 minutes in the shower as you're cleaning yourself.
I take very long showers. Look,
yeah, what did you think about
it? I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
I watched it. Here's the thing. First of all,
I'm just on my own. I'm just going to move. I'm moving to London, folks. I'm out of here. I'm moving.
No, no, no. I mean, I'm moving. Like, we're going to talk about this a little bit later. Like, Downton Abbey, like, I'm a huge fan of British television. It's so high quality. It's wonderful. Mm. I adore you so much. Like, every time our group text goes off and I have a little mini panic attack, and he's all like, only Benedict Cumberbatch tonight. Only. It's nine. It's a film. It's not a show.
It was
a TV movie.
I thought it was an episode. It's a TV
you
movie.
You sold us a false bill of goods. I'm like, check out this new show.
What else are you hiding up in that beard? Four-hour thing.
Besides money and CBS All Access membership. you highfalutin son of a...
Oh, man. But, all right, so...
But here's the thing. No, there are... I mean, I guess a few supernatural spoiler elements to it because we have... Should we just say it? I don't know.
Well, we can just say that basically, like, his daughter... Like
She's abducted. Like, he turns around and she's gone. And we never find her.
No, they see her. And there's other visions that... I don't want to spoil. I want you guys to watch it because I'm sure it's going to come to the States at some point. I don't know what network's going to pick it up.
Can't wait.
This is just the best show. It is called
The Child in Time based off of a book. And it's well done. It's well done. It's very good.
It's very brutal, though. It's really emotional.
It's a tough watch, but it's only 90 minutes. Not like it's 2 hours. It's 90 minutes of heartache.
Oh, it's like 2 hours.
I have that 30 minutes to watch an episode of Ridiculousness.
Watch The Child in Time. You know what? All right. You know, I'm done. The great British breakdown is over. It's done. It's over.
No. We love it so much. I mean, they were great. Their chemistry was great. It was really, really well done.
Should we play you, David, out?
Yes.
That's a horn violin. It's a hornolin. You guys are welcome. Oh my goodness, a viohorn. Viohorn.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Viohorn Davis. That is her sister who is in I Got Away With Murder. Shocker.
Wow.
Welcome to Pun Town.
We're just crushing it today.
We're just crushing it today. Right. Yeah, I feel like we're totally like the kids who are like, summer breaks next week.
The audience has no idea what Child in Time is. They have no idea. They're like, what was that show about?
I mean, but here, you know what? I'm happy I watched it.
Very good.
It's a little heavy-handed. It's heavy. For 6 a.m. in the morning, but I enjoyed it.
Nailed it.
But
okay, moving on. Now, a lot of you, before I let Grace introduce this, because she is the best, I will say this. You guys wondered why the show was titled what it was today. Is Game of Thrones the greatest show of all time? Well, Grace is going to tell you.
Yep, I am. I'm going to tell you right now. So Rotten Tomatoes. Good God.
Fried Rotten Tomatoes.
It's a good movie.
That's my favorite movie about not liking movies.
They had everybody vote and they put together this list of what they're saying are the top 10 best television shows of the past 20 years. Should I just do like a quick rattle off?
Yeah, why don't you do the top 10 and then we can argue about it.
From 10 to 1, this is what it is, starting with 10. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Doctor Who, West Wing, Downton Abbey, Law & Order, Seinfeld, Friends, Big Bang, Breaking Bad, Game of Thrones.
Now see here, if it was called Big Bang and not The Big Bang Theory, it was just called Big Bang and it was like about...
People banging?
Don't worry about it. I'm not
just people
it.
Banging?
Yeah, that's a different show.
Yeah, correct. So these were fans that voted on this.
Right.
And I poured over this list. There's multiple that go in here. I really have a tough time with a bunch of these shows that are in here.
Right.
Hopefully not Downton Abbey.
Downton Abbey is glorious.
No, Downton Abbey for sure.
Yes.
Breaking Bad, I think, deserves it because when it first came out, that's a big show. I mean, that was a big show.
I'll give you the Law and Order.
Not now, but
yeah, I mean, maybe
after
top
20
15.
Seasons.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, there's if you want to put it in the term of sports, and I know this doesn't really help you, but like, listen, you know. So-and-so played 20 years in the league. That didn't mean the last 5 years he didn't ride the pine. Like, this is Law and Order.
That's what I'm saying. Riding those pines.
But Law and Order is good. It's spun off a billion things. But I don't think it deserves to be top 10 shows of all time.
Like,
it's hard to put a procedural in there for me. Something like, listen, I get the fandom of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. I get it. I was never a fan myself. I get that Doctor Who's been on TV for 50 years. That, again, goes on to the thing of Is it longevity or is it results? Breaking Bad was only five seasons of brilliant television. Game of Thrones isn't over yet. For you to put it at number one on the show, like, what if the finales suck? I'm not saying they're going to. I'm not saying, but I don't think it's the greatest show of all time. It's event TV. It's amazing. Mm-hmm. It's well done. The writing is great. The production value is insane. But is it the greatest television show of all time?
For me, Mad Men's my favorite. And it's at number 20. I know it's all subjective. For me, it'd probably be Mad Men, Sopranos, and The Wire.
See, look, shows like The Sopranos
and The Simpsons and
The Wire aren't on here. The Simpsons isn't on.
The Wire's there, but not in the top 10. You're right. Yeah, The Wire.
Where's Friday Night Lights? Where's Sex and the City? Where's 30 Rock? Where's Parks and Rec? Where's Arrested Development? Where's American Vandal?
Well, I mean, Deadwood's at 40.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Deadwood's a good show.
I mean, but here's the thing about TV. It's like if we did a top 10 Sex and the City's 25. Film. Well, that's too low. If we did a top 10 of the, like, you know, because film, for the most part, is film. There's comedy, there's drama, there's action, whatever. TV can be any length of time. It can be 90 minutes. It can be 23 minutes. It can be any kind of format. So it's like a very, 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 very broad
thing. Like NCIS is higher than Mad Men. It's like,
Stranger
Things already?
Yeah, it's already on
like,
there.
Stranger Things is good, but I'm not behind like the Stranger Things hype. Like it's like this greatest show of all time. I like Stranger Things.
It's a great show.
It's a good show. It's not great. I don't know if it's great.
My life hasn't changed because of it.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was so fun to
Mad Men has changed my life. Yeah. The Wire's changed my life. Stranger Things is entertaining. But it hasn't changed
Friday
my life.
Yeah, like Friday Night Lights like made me a better human being.
Yeah.
Stranger Things, I enjoyed it's the fun. Shit out of.
It's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like don't bully people, and also if your best friend gets eaten by a demigorgon, go you should probably look her. You can probably go find her.
ER I get, because again, iconic when it first came out. ER's been on, you know, ER when it first came out was iconic. I mean, and had a great cast too.
Right.
But
and I'm happy The Good Wife was on there somewhere, like 30-something.
Yeah, I agree with Seinfeld and I agree with Friends. Those are seminal shows. The Big Bang Theory is the worst.
I don't know how the Big Bang Theory is top three.
I mean, I guess because the people that watch that show
it's the number one watched
thing.
Comedy, yeah.
I mean,
yeah, I don't know. I mean,
you're
it's
really
just
missing out on some really great TV in this top
10. Yeah, no Parks and Rec in the top 50 or top 40?
Yeah, or 30 Rock.
No 30 Rock.
It's
and honestly, I would make it. Was American Crime Story OJ versus
that's
the
first
on
one.
There?
It's a limited series.
No, it's limited. Yeah, there's no mini series.
That's still TV.
True.
Yeah,
true.
But there's no Band of Brothers. I don't think they're counting mini series on here.
Oh, well, then that should be
that's
a different
list.
Category.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because I thought that was just like
well, yeah, that's
so
the case.
Point,
Band of Brothers should be top 10.
Listen,
right? Yeah.
Game of Thrones is top 10. Breaking Bad. Top five for sure. Game of Thrones and Breaking Bad are top five.
Mad Men for me, top 10 at least.
Okay, top 10 at least. Mad Men.
And Downton Abbey is phenomenal.
That's a top 10 show.
Phenomenal.
Seinfeld, Simpsons.
Yeah, you throw those
and
in
Friends.
There.
Friends. I think.
Yeah, I agree with
fair.
Friends. I think
Friends.
Those are all.
I love Friends.
There's just so many shows out there that making a top 10 is very, very difficult, but I don't agree with this top 10.
And it's also hard too because it's like Game of Thrones and Big Bang Theory like could not be further from one another.
And it's
like,
also this is a fan one, you know. Yeah. So I mean, of course, Game of Thrones and Big Bang Theory are some of the two most watched shows in the world. So of course they're gonna.
I understand Game of Thrones. I don't know.
Yeah. Well,
I don't know things.
If you want us to ever do a ranking show, or you want to see us try
cool,
and
like
argue
our, own
our
personal,
way through,
yeah.
maybe like a top 50. I would love to do that. So maybe we'll talk to the brass and try and figure something else like that, because making top 10s and arguing about it is what the internet was made for. Just don't insult women. Don't insult racial people, people of other races. Racial people. What's wrong with me? Don't insult other people. Don't insult personally. Just insult your opinion. That's what makes this world great. Don't insult it. It's a healthy conversation about love and appreciation of television. All right. Grace, you want to do some Twitter questions?
Yeah, I was actually just peeking over these. I kind of like this from our friend at Jay Golden Eyes.
What's up, Golden Eyes?
Jay Golden Eyes, hello.
That's what they called me back in the day. Jay Golden Eyes. What's up?
He says,
big browns are made of 24 karat gold. Magic in the air.
What life topic do you feel has not been covered well on TV?
You know what I always hated on TV is when parents freaked out about drinking or like smoking pot. There should be like a healthy conversation about, listen, I know that you're in high school and I know that you're going to drink. I know that you're in high school or college or whatever. And I don't know why they would go to college. I'm just saying, I know that like kids are going to experiment. It's the responsibility of the parent to be like, listen, don't try the crazy stuff. And if you're going to do it, do not drive a car. Don't be like, you kids and your drugs, you're going to get sent to military school for smoking one half of a joint. You're all dead to me. But can you believe he did that, Betty? Our whole family's ruined.
Like, can't wait for you to have children, Josh.
Like, Papa you Macuga. Don't overreact. Talk to your kids. Don't, look, you know what show, the episode you should watch? The episode where so-and-so tries pot and their life is ruined after one hit of the weed. You know, guys, it's, you like, the overreaction of television, especially on network TV, I've always hated that stuff.
Yeah. David, what are your thoughts?
I don't know, a subject matter, that's, I feel like they've covered so much. Have we seen, like, no, I guess Modern Family, no. I don't know. I've seen almost everything. I feel like they've covered so much on television. I don't know if they've left out.
Because, see, the reason why I like this question is that I don't know that I've ever seen me on TV. You know what I mean? Like, I've never seen a character that I'm like, oh, shit, that's me.
Well, before, right. You know what I mean? At first, I would have said, I mean, for me, like, Black-ish and, like, The Cosby Show, I felt did a great job, like, representing kind of, like, where I came from. Mm-hmm. Especially The Cosby Show. I mean, yeah. My dad's a doctor. My mom's a counselor, family counselor. So, I mean, like, for me, like, The Cosby Show is kind of my minus the other crazy stuff that's happened like, more recently. That's kind of what my family was like. So I think they've covered, I think they've covered a lot. Yeah.
And I think recently Black-ish and Fresh Off the Boat and shows like that have done, and because we were talking about it yesterday.
Atlanta is a different take. Atlanta's a great unique. Different Atlanta's take. Very good. Yeah.
You know, I think there's a lot of shows that have tackled racial inequality and the color, whatever is happening in the United States really well lately.
Yeah.
In a funny way. I mean, we were talking about that Culture Clash show, and it's really tough because a lot of those shows back in the day were like, hey, our neighbor's different. Let's make a comedy about how different.
Yeah, Master of None with, you know, Aziz Ansari. Like
perfect. Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, neighbor. Look at him. It's Wilson. Look at our new neighbors. They're different. So I think that the TV has really started to do a really great job of tackling issues. Mm-hmm. That's all.
Yeah.
Grace, thank you for always taking the Twitter questions. You're the best.
Thank you.
I'm going to miss you guys terribly while I'm away. But before I do, should we do a... since I'm leaving for a little over 2 weeks, and John Rocha is going to be sub-hosting, same with Grace and David and Emma. If while I'm gone and you could pick one TV character to sit in this seat and do TV talk with you, who would it be?
Oh, a TV character.
Yes.
Oh.
There's only one man who is capable of hosting this, and he is right behind Josh Macuga there, Mr. Benedict Cumberbatch himself.
Really?
Can you imagine Cumberbatch hosting the show? Oh, it'd just be just class all the way. Just class.
All right.
But we probably couldn't go off on tangents, though. Wouldn't
exactly.
Probably, he'd probably be a little like, rainy in a little bit. Like, David, you got to... Go easy, son. Go easy.
Okay.
I don't know if he talks like that.
Gross.
Yeah. I don't think he does.
He talks like that. That's not my dad's
Well, I have two choices. They're on opposite sides of the spectrum for different reasons. As I've said before, Glenn on Superstore is my favorite. So okay. I would either want him or for other ulterior reasons, I would want Khal Drogo.
Oh,
that would be intense.
What?
Momoa's intense.
Momoa's intense. He's
dude.
An intense guy. Really, a sweetheart of a dude that could just crush anybody's skull.
Also, I'm going to share a fun piece of trivia. I have his phone number, his cell phone number.
Whoa.
I'm not going to tell you what it is, but I got it.
Let's put the text there up on the line. Text Khal Drogo at 1-800. My body has been resurrected by a queen witch, and now I'm weird looking. I would just pick Amy Poehler from Parks and Rec because she would keep this place in line.
Damn,
but also
so
hysterical.
Gosh,
and she would make those nice folders
that
she does.
That's why you are the boss. Mm-hmm. That's a great answer.
That'll do it for us on a TV talk on a Sassy Tuesday. I'm going to miss you guys terribly. Thank you for all the kind-hearted well wishes for my upcoming nuptials and my honeymoon and everything you guys do by watching the show every day. We really, really appreciate it. Before we get out of here, David Griffin, where can the good people find you on the internet?
You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at GriffinDE. I'll also be back on Movie Talk on Friday and TV Talk on Friday with Mr. Rocha and Sneed DeFries, I think.
Sneed DeFries. Yeah. Grace.
Cool. And you guys can find me online everywhere at Mrs. Grace Face. We're going to miss you.
I'm Josh Macuga, at Josh Macuga on Twitter and Instagram. I'm going to miss you guys. The Josh Macuga Show on YouTube. If you guys still find it in your heart, we're still waiting to hear if Epic Happy Hours goes to series. So just tag Travel Channel, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Thank you guys, as always, for watching this show. Keep watching when John Rocha is here. The whole crew is going to hold this whole show together. A lot of stuff going on at New York Comic Con they're going to be talking about. I'm going to miss the premiere of a lot of those DC shows. But when I come back, I'm coming in hot with all kinds of the same opinions and smart-ass snarkiness. Special thanks to Adam and Cody for always keeping this show hot every single day, 11 a.m. PST, right here on Collider Video. As always, put down the book, pick up the remote. Hey, everybody, Josh Macuga here. Thanks so much for watching this episode of Collider TV Talk. Want to watch more episodes? Click there. It's an interactive link. Or for more Collider content, click down there. Subscribe to the channel. Tell all your friends. Get an airplane. Drive it by that says Collider. I'm not telling you to buy an airplane. Just do whatever you want as long as you're watching Collider videos.